The idea that we all evolve collectively is, in fact, and I quite mean it, a lovely idea. But it doesn't quite work if you have very keen eyesight. After all, it's easy to empathize with a construct, with an imaginary wounded child. It's very easy to say, well, we deeply care for all the wounded children that may exist in the world. Although they have adult bodies, we believe they have emotional, childlike and frail states. And we can, of course, empathize implicitly with the very idea. But if we really believed that we all evolved together, then we need to actually perceive what is really out there and not just this concept of wounded children everywhere. Because that is a wonderful, voluptuous, very emotional thing to entertain. But if we want to think, well, who are the needy nowadays? Well, there are a lot of people in different countries, Nigeria, Ghana, India, that are forced to get into scamming other people in order to survive because they really do not seem to have other economic options. Are they not the wounded children of the world? And wouldn't it be logical, given that they are, in the true material sense, those who cannot really achieve much except by descending to the low level of becoming scammers, isn't it necessary to empty our pockets on their behalf? I mean, let's get real. There are really deeply affected people affected by the economy, people affected by global inequality. And isn't it right for you to do something about it, do something that is material and very substantial, rather than coming onto my YouTube channel and drawing attention away from the content that I make by talking about wounded children all the time? Why always bring it back to these entities? Who are they? Do we even know them? And if we did know them, what would be the consequence and what would be the cost?